European infrastructure is aging. Decades of use, population growth, and changing environmental conditions are taking their toll. Managing this deterioration is tricky because it's not always clear how to best identify and repair structural flaws early, before they cause safety issues or require a major financial investment to fix. An innovative new training program aimed to help solve this issue. The program, called TRUSS, was a Marie Skłodowska-Curie innovative training network sponsored by the European Commission. The broad goal of the program was to ensure that Europe's buildings, roads, railways, ships, and energy plants continue to serve the population safely for decades to come. The program fostered a unique pairing of academic training and industrial application with a bit of public outreach thrown in. The participants included 14 early-stage researchers, also called ESRs, who were recruited from all over the world. Each participant was expected to complete structured training, perform novel research, and publicly disseminate their work. For their efforts, the ESRs received doctoral degrees, not to mention an excellent head start on a productive career in infrastructure preservation. The highly collaborative multidisciplinary training network consisted of 6 universities, 11 industry participants, and 1 research institute from 5 European countries. Each ESR was assigned a main supervisor from one institution and a co-supervisor from another. Aside from hands-on experience at the main hosting institution, training consisted of secondments at other institutions within the TRUSS network. The ESRs also participated in network-wide meetings every 6 months that included intensive, highly focused modules on different topics related to the assessment of structural safety, as well as on business and entrepreneurial skills. At these meetings, the ESRs also gave seminars on the state of their research projects. This setup gave the ESRs exposure to different sectors, access to a wide range of subject matter experts, and a chance to work on communication skills. The focus of the research projects was varied. One topic of interest was understanding the structural soundness of concrete. For example, Sofia Antonopoulou looked at the reliability of concrete structures made with braided fiber-reinforced polymer rebar to avoid corrosion. Shanur Alam Shorov examined methods for reducing uncertainty in assessing concrete strength in existing structures. Energy infrastructure was another focal point. Alberto González Marino identified processes to reduce uncertainty in the design of freestanding nuclear spent fuel racks, while Rui Teixeira studied practices for optimizing the design of offshore wind turbine towers. In the realm of Europe's nautical interests, Guangzhou examined a framework for managing fatigue cracks in ship structures, and Julia Milana investigated ways of assessing the residual life of ship unloaders. Over half the ESRs focused on rail and road infrastructure. Many sought to improve how we monitor bridge health. Farhad Huseynov looked at ways of assessing bridge condition using rotation measurements, while John Moody measured vibration levels for similar purposes. Matteo Vagnali investigated condition monitoring and fault diagnosis methods to evaluate railway bridges. And Barbara Heitner incorporated damage indicators into bridge safety models that can be used to pinpoint how and where a bridge is likely to break down. A couple of ESRs worked on developing new technology to assess structural safety. Antonio Barrias moved forward the application of distributed fiber optic sensing to monitor bridge structural health, while Daniel Martinez Otero designed an instrumented vehicle based on the capabilities of the traffic speed deflectometer that can detect when a bridge has been damaged. Technology was also a popular method for tracking road conditions. Federico Perotta used trucks outfitted with sensors to assess how pavement is holding up and affecting fuel consumption. And Si-Yon Chen looked at ways of automatically monitoring road infrastructure using unmanned aerial vehicles. But it wasn't all training and research. Those who initiated TRUSS were keenly aware of the importance of disseminating results, both to fellow professionals and to the public at large. All ESRs helped host events geared towards teaching students at all levels the fundamentals of structural failure. Each ESR was also expected to share their work in lay terms through blogs and social media. Overall, TRUSS showed the power of bringing together high-quality intersectoral and multidisciplinary training in structural safety to the next generation of researchers. The unique design of the initiative allowed individual training programs at university and in industry to leverage their full potential by engaging with each other at an international level. The hope is that the expertise gained through this endeavor will reveal cost-effective, environmentally friendly ways of preserving Europe's infrastructure for the next generation.